Well, it's what, 9th of December, 10th of December. Cider's still fermenting. They're all sort of bulging up and releasing the pressure. You can see that one's sort of open and been released, and the lid's gone down. But if I shut it, it'll bubble back up again. But what we're doing today, been on eBay, bought all that lot for 20 quid. Oak timber that I'm going to use to make another press rack. What we've figured out is the press we've got can actually fit one more cheese in vertically, so we can increase the size of it if I make another press rack. So this video is, I'm going to do a detailed one because the other ones are a bit rubbish. There's just pictures every now and again, but this time going to video it. And one of the first things you need is well, you can do it by a handsaw, but it takes a long time. But chop saw, we're just going to start.
Spread the ends up, measured 62. So essentially, we're making these 62 long, and we'll probably get three out of each piece. You can see this bit's wider. So we're actually going to thin it down to that kind of size, and then there's going to be kind of three cut out of it. So now we're going to trim them all down. Just stop for a second on this next stage. Essentially what we're doing is we're cutting battens, so they're 15 millimeters in that direction and 25 millimeters in that direction, and they're going to get put through a planar thicknesser. So we're essentially, each one of those gets cut up into three on there. And I know I've not got the guard on again, and this is the very machine which annihilated my thumb, and that is the very blade which annihilated my thumb. So I am being so careful, just steadily cutting away. I'm about halfway through, so yeah, just stopped to do a bit of videoing.
And this is Mark Hoover in the patio.
Have to vacuum a patio.
So today we've carved up the wood. I've just someone's taken the other half of the, I only used half of what was in the pile. Someone's taken the other half away and paid me 20 quid, so the oak's really not cost anything to make this extra press rack. And there's about 50 battens there that are all 15 millimeters by 25 millimeters. So next week I'll borrow a thicknesser planer and we'll put all those through it, and we'll end up with the kind of 9mm by 20mm bits. So sort of bit, but you kind of make it bit by bit and steadily away. So we're just still making the wood at the moment, and I'll do some more videos of marking it all out and drilling the holes and countersinking and screwing and gluing it all together, and finally finish with varnishing it. This is continuing on the videos of making a cider press rack. The other day we cut all those up using the circular saw, the table saw, the one that mangled my thumb, and essentially slice them into battens that are 25 wide and 15 deep. And I found that with the equipment we've got, that gives you enough room to manoeuvre. And so I've got this in another video, but we're going to essentially reduce it down to that size now. That's an old one. There's enough there. I only need 42, and there's more than 42 there. So what we've done is borrowed one of those, Essentially, we're going to start putting it through. There's one person one side and one person the other, and essentially, I'm going to feed it under that bottom bit, and you can change the height and essentially start trimming it down so the 25mm length side become, or the width side becomes 20mm. Then we'll turn them over 90 degrees and use the thicknesser to reduce the 15mm section down to 9. So we're ready to go. That's just in case we have any that need squaring up. As I say, it's not 100% accurate the way we cut them up, so just in case if any need squaring up, we'll just quickly square it up with that and then put them through the planer. And I've just heard the dog go, so that must be Lewis, so we're about ready. We've been at it for about 20 minutes and we're now 20mm wide and we're about 13mm that way, so we've got another 4mm to take off, so another 4 passes. And we're literally just going from one side to the other. So we're nearly there. Glasses on. Last night we put all these through the thicknesser planer, so now we've got 42 battens, 62 centimetres long in the right dimensions to start marking up to make the press rack. So we'll do that a little bit later. We're just marking up the main three battens. There are two layers to this press rack. There's a bottom layer going one way and the top layer going the other. And three battens on the top layer have screws that go into all the battens on the bottom layer. So I'll just mock it up kind of thing. Now these are 20mm wide, there's a 10mm gap, another 20mm batten, then a 10mm gap. So if you can imagine, that one's going to be about there, that one's going to be in the middle, and that one's going to be in there. And every single position on these three battens needs a hole drilling through it and countersinking, so we can drill a stainless steel screw through this piece onto that piece and hold it together and kind of build up the bottom layer so it goes all the way along. So you end up with a full bottom layer and these three pieces holding the bottom layer together. Now, because it's 20 wide and 20 wide there, the first hole needs to be bang in the middle, so 10mm away from there and 10mm away from there. And then the next one is actually 10mm to there, then 10mm over that gap, then another 10mm to the centre, so it's actually 30mm away. So all the way down here, we go the first one 10mm, 30mm, 30, 30, 30, 30, going all the way along, and the last one there should be 10mm away from the end. We need to do that to the three battens. I've seen other press racks where the fixings go in an angular pattern, and I just thought this was simplest. It just kind of holds it together in a basic fashion and gets the main structure going, and then you can deal with filling in these gaps on the top layer once the bottom layer's in. So just starting to mark it up. So we need a pencil line halfway in between both edges, so right the way down the middle of that piece from one end to the other, which I'm just going to mark up now. I've finished drilling the first one. There's one hole that's slightly out of place, which is that one. It's probably about a millimetre out, but that's the first of the main battens drilled and screwed. And the easiest way to do it is get one of these things with a drill bit and a countersink on the same on the same tool, so you can kind of do it all at once. And really all I'm doing is just doing it. I haven't got a workshop, I've just got to do it how I can. So just doing it on the end of this table. Now all the three main ones have been drilled. So first hole 10 mm from each end, every hole 30 mm gap. So now garbage in the background. Not going to be able to fit them all on, but start getting the general idea. At the end. So that's a kind of mock-up. There's not enough there, but basically you screw it into those and see I've marked,
well, I don't know if you, well, just about, yeah, I've marked 10 mm in from each edge and made a cross. So there's going to need to be additional holes drilled in there, because I mentioned if you don't drill the holes in the bottom bit, it'll split. And essentially when all those holes are drilled, you can start to glue it together, and then you can put that one on and use that one as a guide to drill the holes in the middle, and you're half done. So that's it for the moment. Right, I've glued and screwed the first two main bits in, so you can actually see the overall shape and size of it. Essentially, I've just been glued and screwed up, and to make sure, well, they don't have to be exactly square, but essentially use the set square to make sure they're square. The next one goes in the middle, so you need to mark the middle position, both sides on these bits, which I'll do now. So we've, well, I've put the middle one in, so that's basically the frame. And then, one by one, work your way down, using those holes as locators. Drill a small hole. Is that? That's quite short. Start going down and installing the rest of them in the bottom. I'm slowly putting the battens in. You can see there's 7 in. It doesn't really matter which order you put them in. Just have to steadily go along the rack. I'm gluing and screwing and gluing.
weatherproof wood adhesive, but it's going to be inside a load of lacquer, so basically once it's put together, the glue's sealed in, so it's not really important that it's sort of food friendly or food compatible. So still a green spirit. So that's the bottom half done and all held together. It's probably taken about 40 minutes, half an hour maybe, 40 minutes. It's not 100% accurate. If you look, there's some of them stick out, some of them don't. They're all within a couple of mil, so it's, you know, it's accurate enough. And that's the bottom part. And now, all these ones that are left need holes. A hole drilling there. Those screwing in and the rest of them jointed and the weight put on. And then you put each of those on and you move left and right. Or right and left, even. So, just finishing this rack off. I've done videos of sort of putting the bottom together. And on these, the ends have been drilled 10mm in and from the end and 10mm in from the side. Both ends. And essentially, marked up there where it needs to be, so you can line it up. You can then use that hole to drill a pilot hole for your screws. Do that both sides, which I'll do now. Right, so we've got the holes drilled. There's two little pilot holes there. And you get your glue. You can use the batten that you're going to stick down as a guide to roughly get them in the right place. So they're all in. Sit that on there. And screw it in. As you can see, I've put these in. You slowly go across, and once you screw it in, then you've got to put a heavy weight on to hold that down all the way across and make sure it's bonded properly. So you put the top bit on. Now here, half of it's been sanded. This half has been sanded. That half hasn't. So these have got really sharp square edges. And these are now nice and round. There's nothing to catch on. So that's the only thing left to do is varnish. And that's another press rack done. 18 millimeters thick, so it's made out of wood, nice and thin, very strong, flexible. You've seen what we've done with it. We've had a 30 ton press on the top of them, and it takes it, so yeah, can't have gone too far wrong with that.